الصحابة there is something happened to them after the battle of Uhud. They've been defeated, right? From the kuffar. The kuffar, they killed 70 of the sahaba, shaheed, يعني. But they come to the point, they said, why? Why to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why Allah is not supporting us? Why Allah is not helping us? Like Muslims nowadays, right? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaving these Muslims, the countries to be like this, what we see every day, somebody in Lebanon, somebody in Yemen, somebody in whatever, but they count in Gaza, of course, this is the main problem. Subhanallah, and Palestine. There are too many calamities and trials and I can say afflictions and hardship, problems. Allah is testing us. And some Muslims, their iman is very light. They ask this question, why? Are you asking Allah why? That question happened also from the Sahaba after the Battle of Uhud. And Allah answered him, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. بس كده. بس نصر الله not حسن نصر الله. No. نصر الله the victory of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is coming to the Muslims with some conditions. It's not just like that. You know how Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam suffered a lot, was preparing a lot, was working hard. And he's the same one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any reason, without any means, he sent Jibreel and he took him up to the seventh heaven in part of the night and he bring him back. But when he moved from Mecca to Medina, he was preparing with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and you know the story of al-Hijrah. Subhanallah, it's a lot of preparation. فإنت كمسلم, you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for victory. You have to work for it. First of all, you have to come to Allah. When I see you in Salat al-Jama'a, means you are looking for victory. This is the basics. I'm talking about the basics. When you stand in the row and you guard Salat al-Jama'a, you read your Quran, you come to the masjid, I'm going to say this is a sign of al-Iman. This man, now he's in the row. He's in the line. He's the one really, practically, he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for al-Nasr. For that's why we don't, يعني احنا we are not doing nothing. يعني بلد, I'm sorry, يعني like Saudi Arabia, I saw a video today. There is a lady, she sent me that video, not me, it was TikTok. And this part is what they are doing in Saudi Arabia. There is some people, they are singing the Quran, Surah Al-Qiyamah. I have the video. They are singing the Quran with the music. كلا لا وزر, with the rap, like استغفر الله العظيم. And how they allow this in the بلد this is Saudi, يعني يخرب بيته بلد أمم السودة. How they allow this from the extremist to Wahhabi to خربانين مرة واحدة كده. There is no moderation أبدا. بعد that's why we've been calling them millions of times moderation in Islam, moderation in Islam. From الكفر الكفر extremist now to nothing. No Islam at all. No. Islam is different. Islam came there, let's teach you Islam. You know? يا جماعة الخير والله سبحان الله فتت شوي يعني البلاء أو الابتلاء يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى this trials الله سبحانه وتعالى assisting the believers فdon't be sad brothers and I want you to be sure that Allah is still there and Allah سبحانه وتعالى he's in control but it's Allah is examining us for too many reasons might be to raise your rank in Jannah might be to wipe your sin might be to forgive your sin or might be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is subhanallah for too many things might be Allah azza wa want you to come closer to him to strengthen your iman for taqweet al-iman subhanallah is examining us more Allah is examining you more maybe you're going to turn your face to Allah and you ask Allah for forgiveness subhanahu wa ta'ala that's why Allah azza wa يعني is really he want us to rely on him to ask for him for forgiveness سبحانه وتعالى and to make دعاء more to him and also might be you have a lot of sin Allah سبحانه وتعالى want you to forgive your sin صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith ما يصيب المسلم من نصب ولا وصب ولا هم ولا حزن ولا أذن حتى الشوكة يشاكها إلا كفر الله بها أو بها كفر الله من خطاياه ف this purification from the sin destroyers the expiate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it like a means to expiate your sin this is what he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said no
fatigue, nor disease, nor sorrow, nor sadness, nor hurt, nor distress befalls a Muslim, even a thorn that pricks him, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expiates some of his sins because of that. So don't be sad. Why? Don't keep. Why Allah is keeping these people sick in the hospital? Why Allah being killed? Is keeping this Muslim being killed? Why you put it in the shoulder of Allah? Put it in your shoulder. Your failure, don't put it in my shoulder. Put it in your. Keep it in your shoulder. See what's wrong with you and fix it. This is a point. Everybody's complaining, and I get my failure. I put it on Brother Ali's shoulder, and the Brother Ali's get about it somebody's shoulder. Why we're gonna be like this? Subhanallah. So that's why Allah examining us just to bring him, to bring us back to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing your faith too. Like Sahaba, after the battle of Uhud, subhanallah. Allah, they asked the same thing. Even one of the Sahaba, Khabbab ibn al-Arat, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was laying down around the Kaaba, it was summer, hot, and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping, taking like a nap. Khabbab, he was saying, Ya Rasulullah, ala tasansar Allah lana, Ya Rasulullah. We are not asking Allah for us, Ya Rasulullah. These people, they are killing us in the streets of Mecca, Ya Rasulullah. يعني, subhanAllah, even Umar ibn Khattab himself, when Allah sent in Surah Al-Qamar, verse number 45, سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمْعُ وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبُرْ بَلِ السَّاعَةُ مَوْعِدُهُمْ وَالسَّاعَةُ أَدْهَى وَأَمَرْ. SubhanAllah. I was explaining yesterday the story of Qarun. Today, inshallah, I'm going to finish Surah Al-Qasas. And subhanAllah, Allah Azza wa Jal, he mentioned the punishment of Qarun in dunya. By the way, Qarun from Dr. Ibrahim City. Qarun Fayyum. What happened is, Qarun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he showed us his punishment in the dunya, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave order to the earth to swallow him in his palace. But he did not mention his adab in the punishment in the akhir. Of course, he can have punishment in the akhir. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمْعُ, the kuffar of Quraysh, وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبُرْ, بل الساعة موعدهم, there is a punishment also, they will be punished in dunya in the battle of Badr, and also بل الساعة موعدهم thereafter, والساعة أدهى وأمر, the severe punishment. And Umar ibn al-Khattab, during that time, he said, what kind of jam'ah this ayah is talking about? We cannot even, we're not able to defend ourselves in Mecca. And the Sahaba, they immigrated twice to Abyssinia. And we will be killed in front of ours. We cannot defend ourselves. Where are these jam'ah? They're going to flee from us. When the battle of Badr comes, and Umar ibn al-Khattab, he saw this kuffar, they are fleeing from the Sahaba, from the Malaika and the Sahaba, and Sayyidina Umar, he repeat the ayah himself, he said, سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمْعُ وَيُؤْلُونَ الدُّبُرِ بَلِ السَّاعَةُ مَوْعِدُهُمْ وَالسَّاعَةُ أَدْهَى وَأَمَرُ. So that's why, subhanAllah, let's testing our faith. Sahaba after Uhud, they said, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمْ يَأْتُكُمْ مَثَلَ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِن قَبْلِكُمْ. Do you think you're going to go to Jannah like this without any test, without any trials or affliction or problem or hardship? Just say Jannah is easy? No, you have to face this. That's why I say all the time, طريق الجنة, the way of Jannah, it is not a rosy way. It's not a rosy way. Nobody just can go to Jannah just like that. You have to be examined. You have to be examined. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing one's faith. This is by these trials and the difficult time. Yeah, and also increasing reward. Maybe Allah Azza wa Jal, He want to give you more reward, more hasanat. Subhanallah, according to this, subhanallah. So that's why we learn also a sabr, patience, a rida, to be satisfied, satisfaction. Yes, patience is very important. You know, bin khilal al-ibtila wa al-ihtisab. And al-ihtisab, ihtisab yani eh? Al-ajr. When you say ihtisab means, that's whatever is happening to me, inshallah I will get the ajr from Allah. The reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to train you to accept his qada and his qadar. Yes, when I explained yesterday the qissa of story of Qarun or Korah, people, they became two types, remember? One type, they said, we wish if we have like Qarun. Another type, the wise people, they said, no, fear Allah. The word of Allah is better. And when those who've been wishing to have the same money like him and dunya, when they saw his punishment, they said, Alhamdulillah, Allah is favored. He's favored on us. He did not punish us like him. For these people, when you start to become jealous or you look for somebody's issues or whatever in the hand of others and you wish this coming to you and you become envy or jealous of people, subhanAllah, as if you're telling Allah, I'm not respecting your qadr when you distribute your rizq. Yes. Why you make this poor and you make this person ghani or rich? Why you make healthy him healthy and this man is sick? You cannot tell Allah like that. You have to respect the qadr of Allah في الأرزاق and when he distributes his ni'am سبحانه وتعالى to the people. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى is examining you with الابتلاءات, trials and testing, all of that with sabr and a satisfaction and rida. تطهير الذنوب وتقوية الإيمان واختبار الإيمان and you have to rely on Allah سبحانه وتعالى, الاعتماد على الله. All of this and the main point of الابتلاء to come closer to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. More you turn your face to Allah, more Allah سبحانه وتعالى will help you. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to increase your iman. You see somebody, subhanallah, he's in dunya, doing right and left. When a little musibah or calamity happened to him, you see him coming to the masjid. He knew now, he think about Allah now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving me this, might be he want me to come closer to him. That's why, don't be sad. Whatever you see, just do your job, come to the masjid, do your ibadat, read the Quran, be a good Muslim, to yourself, to your family, to the community, to everybody. And just show Allah your goodness. That's all. Everybody individually, if we make that, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. All of you make general tawbah, you might be successful because of that. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا رب العالمين, أن يغفر لنا وأن يسترنا ويجبرنا وأن يرحمنا يا رب العالمين وأن يخفف عن إخواننا في لبنان وفي فلسطين وفي غزة وفي اليمن وفي بلاد المسلمين كلها يا رب العالمين. يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ المسلمين واحفظ ضماء المسلمين وقوي شوكة المسلمين ووحد صفوف المسلمين واهد المسلمين ورد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا يا رب العالمين. حجب نساء المسلمين واهد شباب المسلمين وارحم المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لأبائنا ولأمهاتنا كما ربينا صغيرا يا رب. اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. لك يا رب سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين. يا رب يسر لنا الخير لنا مكان يا رب واحفظنا جميعا من شرور الإنس والجن يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين انظر إلينا نظرة رضا تحرم بها أجسادنا ووجهنا ودماءنا وعظمنا عن النار. واشف من كان منا مريضا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتنا وموت المسلمين رحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. آمين. جزاكم الله خيرا.